Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Ainsley News. It's Thursday, the 15th of April, and we are discussing record leverage and Archegos, the house of cards. Yesterday, we spoke to the explosion of inflation in assets off the back of near free money on offer and Fed Chair Powell's reiteration on 60 Minutes that he will let inflation run before stepping in to change it. Arguably, none more than the US share market has benefited from this debt-fueled largesse. The official figures as of 28th of February for margin debt on Wall Street have exploded to 814 billion, up an eye-watering 49% from a year ago. The last time such gains happened were in 2007, just before the GFC, and 1999, just before the dot-com crash. That figure being lending to buy more shares secured by shares, you would think should be front of mind for the head of every central bank fueling this wild leverage speculation. In the same 60 Minutes interview, when those figures were put to him, Powell incredibly responded as follows. "That sounds like margin debt. I don't know that statistic. I really can't react to that statistic. I would say the main thing that we do is we make sure that the financial institutions that we regulate and supervise understand the risk that they're running, manage them well, have lots of capital, lots of liquidity, and highly evolved risk management systems so that they do understand the risks they are running and have plans to deal with them." Moving past the "I don't know that statistic" mic drop, it is important to look at what he says next, particularly after the Archegos event. The $20 billion collapse of Archegos last month was entirely due to excess leverage and hubris. Importantly, though, the same body monitoring that margin debt, Wall Street self-regulator, FINRA, had absolutely no idea about the scale of leverage used by Archegos through large Wall Street banks such as Credit Suisse, Nomura, Goldman Sachs, and JP Morgan Stanley. Archegos used complicated total return swaps to hide the leverage from the banks, but to be fair, the banks were guilty of not exactly looking either. They are quite lucrative after all. Insiders say Archegos is just one of many using these instruments to circumvent FINRA, the bank's reporting obligations, and rules around the 50% leverage where, for example, Archegos was using 6-to-1 leverage. Archegos was just one of around 3,000 family offices around the world, and combined with other hedge funds, this clever rule-dodging instrument business presents a massive amount of unreported leverage in Wall Street banks. Next, from the Financial Times. The business, which has grown rapidly since the financial crisis, accounts for more than half of banks' total equity financing revenue. Finadium calculates more than traditional margin lending and lending out of shares for shorting combined, synthetic financing continued to take shares from other forms of equity financing in the first half of this year. That, of course, changes that already massive 814 billion and puts it well into the trillions. JP Morgan Chase alone was carrying $2.6 trillion in reported share derivatives as of December 31st, 2020. What is maybe most remarkable about the Archegos collapse is that the market barely shrugged. A $20 billion collapse, including billions in losses in major Wall Street banks, and nothing. The similarities with the long-term capital management LTCM collapse in 1998 is the obvious comparison. That $4 billion collapse rocketed financial markets around the world, seeing huge falls in share markets globally, and saw a US government-instigated bailout fund of $3.65 billion quickly implemented to allow an orderly liquidation. $4 billion compared to $20 billion. Easy money and easy ways around the rules combined with Wall Street greed is a recipe for disaster. Greed and hubris are a dangerous combination. Yesterday, we talked about the opportunities to be had with the access to cheap money to buy assets that could ironically gain from very reasons that cheap money is on offer. The US share market in particular, but a global fallout of its failure by inclusive default, on the other hand, appears to be a highly leveraged house of cards that is anything but. The problem is that the House of Cards could well keep stacking, and lessons of don't fight the Fed post the GFC fresh in investors' minds will see it continue. The problem is the higher the stack, the bigger the fallout of a disorderly unwinding of that leverage on its inevitable fall. That's news today, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. For any gold and silver products, please visit ainsleybullion.com.au. And for any crypto products, please visit ainsleywealth.com.au. Have a nice afternoon, and we'll catch you again tomorrow. Bye.